Hello students, I am Rajesh Tiyar, Assistant Professor Gopalan College of Engineering and Management. Today's topic is First Come First Serve Scheduling. This topic comes in Computer Science. This mainly is used in CPU, where CPU makes scheduling for each task which we provide it. So first, what is First Come First Serve? So First Come First Serve, it's a non-preemptive scheduling algorithm. This method is main feature is follow first in and first out, that is FIFO. FIFO is the short form of follow first in and first out. FIFO strategy assigns priority to the process in order in which they request the processor. Process comes in, add its PCB to the tail of ready queue. Dispatcher selects the first job in the queue and it completes the job. The running process does not give until it terminates. That is, the process does not end until the last task of the given data is done. So here is an example for the FIFO. This example is just given as the process P1, P2, P3. The process P1, P2, P3 are the command which we give. This is the arrival time, that is all given as 0. The burst time 2433. There is a chart called as Gantt chart. Using this Gantt chart, we can make out what is the wait time around turn around time. So it is basically total wait time is the sum of the columns, that is 0, 24, 27, that equal to 51 minutes. Average wait time is equal to total wait time by total number of process, that is 17. So total turnaround time is the sum of all the total turnaround, that is 24 plus 27 plus 30, that gives to 81 minutes. So average is total turnaround time divided by number of tasks or number of processes. So total output is 3 jobs, that is P1, P2, P3 divided by total output, that is 30 seconds, that is 0.1 job per second. That is the main thing, how it calculates the job required. So the advantages of FIFO or FCFS is algorithm does not include any complex logic, or it is just a simple logic which is first in first out. So first in first out is pretty simple and easy to implement. Every process will get a chance to run, so starvation does not occur. That is that means each and every process is done at least once. So the disadvantage is there is no preemption of a process. If a process is started, then CPU executes the process until it ends. There is no shortcut. The whole process should end, then only the next task can be started. Because there is no preemption, if a process executes for a long time, the process in back of the queue will have to wait for a long time before they get any chance to be executed. That means if a task which requires more time, then the next task which is behind it will have a more long time or a lag will be there. So this is an main disadvantages of it. So the resources collected for this PPT is by wikibooks.com, geeksfolks, and so on, like textode.com. Thank you.